he loved the game and he worked so hard for it and just used to come home covered in bruises, sometimes the size of dinner plates, and that it was just tough on him.
We don't know what was going on really with Terry Sawchuk because people weren't exploring that at the time. Even when they did get masks, they weren't adequate. They weren't what we have now. But he mostly played his career before that, where he was putting his face in front of 100 mile per hour pucks, and that is insane.
I was always like, Terry Sawchuk's the greatest goalie I've ever lived. He had this record for shutouts and wins and all that kind of stuff. So you think you know someone, and you think, especially a celebrity or someone like of a high status we're used to seeing, and then you realize you don't. And it's so funny. It was actually a learning lesson for me because you're like, oh, wow, he was like the greatest. I didn't even know when I was a kid that he died at such a young age. He died at 40 years old. I did not know that. There was a lot I didn't actually know. And when I got to the research stage and learning about him, he had a really difficult life. And not only Terry, but a lot of people, a lot of goaltenders, a lot of athletes at that time, they didn't have the freedoms they have now. I mean, physically, not wearing a mask, it seems ridiculous to us now. It's like, oh, how did they not think to do that? But that's the way it was.